Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2280, WB Merge using different columns.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, we're going to take a look at some brand new software that I've been trying out called WB Merge. It stands for Workbook Merge. It's for when you have dozens or hundreds of files and you need those files to all be combined into one workbook. You say, well, isn't this like Power Query? But it has some cool features that Power Query doesn't have. Let's check it out.
All right, so WB Merge is a brand new utility that lets you merge data in different workbooks. But WB Merge can do some things that Power Query can't do. So what I have today, I have four different files, Q1 through Q4. And you see that my headings are not in row 1, they're in row 5. And that always causes problems with Power Query. So we have Apple through Iceberg. And when we move on here to Q2, you'll see that Iceberg is gone and we've added Kiwi and Lime. And then now here in Q3, this is where I really threw it a curveball, because I have the same columns as in the previous ones, but I've completely mixed them up. I sorted this data left to right. All right, and we'll see how it works. If it works, if WB Merge gets this right, we should see these numbers in sequence: 332, 333, 334, 5, and so on. That's what we're hoping. And then here we have some of the columns in common: honeydew, iceberg, jackfruit, kiwi. But then we have some other columns that are not in any of the workbooks. Now, in order to make this work, what we're going to do is we're going to come out here and create one template file, or I don't know, just a sample file. And the headings have to be in row 5, like they are in all of the other items, and a superset of all of the columns that we might ever get. And we want these to be in the order that we want the final file to be. All right, so I'm going to close all this and fire up WB Merge. Okay, so here's the WB Merge application. And the first thing we're going to do is specify a source file. In other words, the file that has all of the headings. And it says, hey, are all of the data headers on row 1 of each worksheet? And I'm going to say no. Point to my all possible columns worksheet and see it works with XLSM, which is beautiful. And in sheet 1, the headers are in row 5. Great, selection is complete. If you had multiple sheets, I guess you could use this to set them all. So selection is complete. Are you done? Yes, workbook successfully loaded. Click OK. All right, so now it knows which columns I want, and I want all of the columns there. All right, then we go on to uncheck strict column merge. Do I want to allow partial column merges? Yes. Strict worksheet merge. Now, in this case, all the workbooks have just one worksheet, so it's really not necessary to uncheck that. And result shading, I'm going to leave that on. I think that's a cool feature. So we choose merge, and we want to add items by files or folders. I'm going to do it by files. So we browse for the folder. WB Merge. The new file is going to be called All Data. They're going to add XLSX to the end. All right, that's great. So we'll add items here. I want Q1 through Q4. I'm not going to include this one because that was just a dummy file that specified all the columns. So we choose Open. All right, and then finally Run Merge. And this is lightning fast. Merge completed successfully in all workbooks. And there's a whole bunch of information here as far as what happened, and I don't pay attention to that at all. All right, let's go check it out in Excel. All right, so here we are. This file is just the same results file, in case you have to go back and check anything. Here's the real file. All right, so apple, banana, cherry, everything looks great for that file 1. I love that they have this file number out here. They also alternate the colors, which is cool. WB null just means there was nothing in these columns. I guess I'd probably do a control H and change all that to just blank cells, which is what I would prefer. Whatever. Okay, so then here in file 2, you see that iceberg was removed and we added kiwi and lime. All right, here's the real test. File 3, where things were completely out of sequence, but thanks to the heading row in row 5, it was able to bring all that back. Nice job there on WB Merge. And then here, where I had a lot of things towards the end of the list and nothing towards the beginning of the list. All right, so, hey, this is cool. It has some flexibility. It was designed for hundreds of files, but this little test here, it's worth checking out. Check the link down in the YouTube description.
Well, there you have it. That's WBMerge. What'd you think? Leave me a note down in the comments below. And if you like this video, please subscribe and ring that bell.
Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.